family members, we're going to record it for you, and we'll have it posted later on. We also have one of our own who's going to be taking some pictures, commemorative pictures. If you want to take a picture, kind of get over to the side so you don't block the screen from the camera. But we're going to have help baptizing today. First guy is our children's pastor, Sean Willicky, pastor of Kids Point. We're really glad Sean's in there. All right. And so I am so excited about these kids. They are ready. Man, you should have seen them back there. They're ready. So our first one to get baptized today is somebody I've actually, man, seen her grow up the last, you know, 6-7 years. And this is Emma Siebert. So Emma's going to come in. Here she is, Emma Siebert. Let me tell you, this girl does not have a shy bone in her body, okay? Emma just turned 9 on Thursday. So what a great day. On Friday. Okay. On Friday, she just turned 9, and she told me she is having a big family birthday party today, and she's getting baptized. All right. Well, you know Pastor Chuck can... Oh, you had it? You already had it? Okay. Okay. Well, all right. I missed some of it, but I'm really glad that you are here. Now, the most important thing, Emma, because we've talked, and you know what? You know it's really special? Because I know you and your dad talked about your salvation, and your dad was there to pray with you, wasn't he? That's really beautiful. Amen. She said she and your dad prayed so that Jesus could come in her heart. So, Emma, as you stand here today, do you know for sure Jesus is your Savior and Lord?
Yes.
Upon your profession of faith in Christ as your Savior and Lord, it's our honor and privilege to baptize you as our sister in Christ. We're buried with Christ in baptism, and we're raised to walk in newness of life with Christ Jesus our Lord. Come over here for a picture. We're going to look right over there. All right. That's awesome. That's awesome. Yeah, I will. Now, our second person to be baptized today is an awesome young man named Stephen Bothell. Stephen, come on in the pool with us. All right. You know, Stephen is such a special young man, and some of you know the story that this year, Stephen and his brothers got a forever family with Michelle Bothell as their adoptive mom. Isn't that awesome? That's wonderful. And Stephen is 7 years old, and he is just really excited about this. Stephen, as you stand here today, do you know for sure that Jesus lives in your heart? Upon your profession of faith in Christ as your Savior and Lord, and in obedience to his command, it's our honor and privilege to baptize you as our brother in Christ. We're buried with Christ in baptism and raised to walk in newness of life with Christ Jesus. Come here, buddy. Let's get a picture over here. Come on, get over here real quick. Awesome, man. Did he dab? Yeah. Next one getting baptized is a very special lady named Kaylee Rowland. And Kaylee is part of our Kids Point team. She works in the ministry with Emma and with Stephen and all of our kids. She's part of Sean's crew. And I am so excited because she just wanted to say, I want to step up today and really express my faith in the Lord. And she is a highly paid professional by day doing medical billing. And on the weekend, she just loves Jesus and serves him. So we're so glad to have her at our church. Amen. Kaylee, as you stand here today, there's your family out there. You know for sure that Jesus Christ lives in your heart. Upon your profession of faith in Christ as your Savior and Lord, and in obedience to him, it's our honor and privilege to baptize you as our sister in the name of Christ. We're buried with Christ in baptism and raised to walk in newness of life in Christ. Woo, yeah. Come over here for a picture. That's awesome. Yeah. This is Sean's first baptism at LifePointe, one of many, we hope, for the years ahead. Thank you, Sean. Now entering the pool is the old guy. Oh, he just had a birthday. Pastor Mike is coming into the pool. Done many of our baptisms over the years. Yeah, we love this guy. And what do we say on three, church? What do I want you to say to him? One, two, three. Happy birthday! All right. And now we have an awesome, incredible young lady who is coming to be baptized. This is Ariel Rodriguez. And yeah, give it up for Ariel. This young lady just has just the sweetest spirit and just the just a smile, always just so upbeat, and we just love her. And you know that guy that plays lead guitar in our band, he kind of brought Ariel here because they kind of have this friendship going on, and so we're really glad that that Cole brought Ariel to our church, and we're so excited about this. And Ariel assured me that her blue hair was not going to leave blue dye in the pool. No, she we laughed about it. Okay, anyway, Ariel, as you stand here today, do you know for sure that Jesus Christ lives in your heart? Upon your profession of faith in Christ as your Savior and Lord, and in obedience to Him, it's our honor and privilege to baptize you as our sister in Christ. We're buried with Christ in baptism and raised to walk in newness of life in Christ. Woo! Jesus. Yeah, let's get a picture over here. I love it. Amen. That's awesome. Fantastic. And last but not least, we have an awesome lady named Trish Burnett who's coming to the baptism pool. Let's hear it for Trish! Now, you know, every baptism has a special backstory. I love this lady so much. I've gotten to know Trish because of this guy coming in the pool, Junior Kohler. Many of you know Junior, of course. Junior and Tammy Lee came to our very first service in this building. It was actually 7 years ago today. This is the anniversary of the first service in our building. And he never left. He just never left. He just stayed. But we love he and Tammy so much and their family. And the backstory is Junior's mom was an incredible lady. And she lived to a ripe old age in her 90s. And she was always a lifelong Lutheran. That was her history. And Trish always took her mom to church. And, you know, she couldn't drive on her own, and so Trish wanted her mom to be at church. But every time they visited, Trish said, "Pastor Chuck, if something ever happens to mom and she goes to heaven, I want to be a part of your church. I want to be a part of this church. I love this church." And several years ago, we said goodbye to your mom. She went to heaven. And Trish came over. And every week, she just inspires me, her joy, her love, her service, her support. And she said, "Pastor Chuck, I just want to really honor the Lord today and follow him in baptism." So we're really excited about that. And she said, I want my brother to be here with me. So he's in the pool with her. And so we're really excited about that. You know, that's how we just build relationships and bring people into the family. So Trish, as you stand here today, do you know for sure that Jesus Christ lives in your heart? Amen. Upon your profession of faith in Christ as your Savior and Lord, and in obedience to his command, it's our honor and privilege to baptize you as our sister. We're buried with Christ in baptism and raised to walk in newness of life in Christ Jesus our Lord. Come over here for a picture. Junior, get over here for a picture. I love you. Oh, I love you. Amen. 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 Hey, the next best thing to being in the water is getting hugged by wet people. I tell you, it's great. Because I love being in the water. I just couldn't do it right now. So listen, this is what the family of God is all about, right? This is what Family of God is all about, sharing the spiritual journey together. And we're going to have another baptism coming up. We've already had some people talking about it. So if you've never followed the Lord in water baptism since you become a Christian, because this water doesn't save you, there's nothing magical about it. Guess what? It's Crowley tap water. It's only Jesus that saves us. What we do in baptism is we say, He lives in my heart, and I want to tell you all about it. That's what baptism is. Amen. So you're invited to be a part of the next one. I'd love to have you. Say, are you glad you came today? Yeah. Well, let's stand up, and we're going to have a prayer and get out of here.